started the Wronskian method. Yeah, so essentially we are studying the second order differential equation, and in second order differential equation we started with first the simplest differential equation, that is linear differential equation, which may be homogeneous, which may not be homogeneous, which may be non-homogeneous depending on the C term, right? And then if the Cx is zero, that means the given differential equation is second order homogeneous linear equation, then its solutions, set of solution, makes a vector space, subspace of continuous functions, and then we'll get so that is a subspace, and whenever we have a subspace we can discuss the vector of that subspace as a linearly dependent or independent. So this is the definition of whether two functions are dependent or it is linearly independent, right? Yeah, so if we get non-zero numbers, one of the alpha and beta is non-zero and alpha f plus beta g is zero, that means f and g are dependent. If both alpha and beta is zero, then they are independent. Yeah, so Wronskian, we define that we are given two functions y1 and y2, which are real valued continuously differentiable functions, and over the interval I, then the Wronskian is nothing but determinant of y1, y2, and y1 dash, y2 dash. So let us see one example first of all. So we are given two functions. First function is cosine x, y1 is equals to cos x. Second function is sine x function, where x belongs to some interval I, which is a subset of real line, right? So I is an interval on the x-axis. So then we need to find out whether what will be the Wronskian in this case. Yeah, so again, the Wronskian is defined as w of y1, y2. Usually we define at a given point, and that is defined as y1x, y2x, y1 dash x, and its derivative of y2 function, determinant of this. So this depends on a particular x where we are finding it. So y1 is the function cos x, so that means this will be cos x, y2 is sin x, derivative of cos x is minus sin x, derivative of sin x is cos x function, right? And then we know that this determinant is nothing but cos square x minus sin square x, that is plus sin square x, and this value is always 1, because we know that for every value of x, cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1 for every value theta. So this is always 1, whatever x we take in whatever interval, it doesn't matter. So in this particular example, Wronskian for every value of x is 1. In general, it may not be true, right? Depending on what functions y1 and y2 we are taking. Yeah, so now we want to see that what is the relation of, so this is how to find the Wronskian for two given functions. But what we are going to do is we are going to use the Wronskian to identify the solutions are independent or dependent. So first of all, let us consider the existence and uniqueness theorem. we are given, consider second order linear differential equation y double dash plus px y dash plus qx y is equals to rx. X belongs to some interval, is a non-homogeneous second order linear differential equation. Where, so what is given is px, qx and rx function. These three functions are continuous, right? And moreover, we are assuming the initial condition. So here this is second order linear differential equation, so that means there will be two conditions in the initial, which is known as initial conditions. So first condition is y of x naught is equal to y naught, and second condition is y dash of x naught is equal to y naught dash, right? Where y naught and y naught dash are some numbers. So whenever such a differential equation is given, what is speciality of this differential equation? So if we compare it with the earlier one, you can see that here the coefficient of y dash is some function, right? But here the coefficient of y dash is 1. So whenever this coefficient of y dash function is non-zero, we can divide the equation by that function px. Since it is non-zero, we can convert in this form, right? And whenever we have this type of equation where coefficient of y double dash is 1, we can apply this existence and uniqueness theorem with the initial condition, and in this case the solution is unique. Then there exists a unique solution right? So and here the solution exists on this particular interval. So solution yx on I. So over the entire interval the solution exists. Yeah, so this is regarding existence and uniqueness theorem for non-homogeneous case. So now we'll discuss corollary of this, which is a homogeneous equation. So we know that whenever we have a system of linear equations, then which is homogeneous, then we always get a trivial solution, right? So same way there is a result here. So here when we consider the differential equation to be homogeneous, so that means, yeah, so consider y double dash plus px y dash plus qx equals to 0 is a homogeneous second order linear differential equation. So here also we are considering corollary, that means we are assuming px and qx are continuous over x belongs to I, each x belongs to the interval. So then from the existence and uniqueness theorem, what we will get is we will get the unique solution. Yeah, so of course there is an initial condition. So moreover, initial condition, because this is equation is homogeneous, the initial condition is we consider the initial condition y of x naught is 0 and y dash of x naught is 0. So the constant which we are taking in this initial condition y naught and y naught dash are essentially 0. So that is our initial condition for the homogeneous case. So whenever we are given homogeneous equation with this initial condition, then we get unique solution. Right, and that solution will be trivial solution. For example, what will be the solution of, yeah, so I forgot to write y here. Uxy is equal to 0. Right? So earlier equation I have written y, but here I forgot. So is it clear that the identical function y is 0 everywhere satisfies initial condition and the given equation? We take a trivial function yx equals to 0 for all x in the interval, then it satisfies this homogeneous differential equation. Is it clear that?
Yes,
sir. Right, because y is 0, y is a 0 function, so y dash is also 0, y double dash is also 0, and since y is 0 everywhere, y is 0 at the point x naught also. In this case, we get unique solution yx is equal to 0 for all x belongs to y. So 0 function is a solution, is a trivial solution of homogeneous equation. So we will be using this result in proving certain results in terms of Wronskian. So the main result is finding the formula of Wronskian. Yeah, so if we have two solutions y1 and y2, be two solutions of the second order of the equation. So we are considering homogeneous equation, which is y double dash plus px y dash plus qxy is equals to 0. We have two solutions of this equation. And again, every time we are considering these functions over an interval I. So fix a point x naught in I. Then for each x belongs to I, the Wronskian can be given by Wronskian of y1 y2 at x naught e power minus integral x naught to x qs ds. Right, so s is just another variable we are using, a variable other than x. So we want to show this formula. Whenever we have two solutions y1 and y2 of this homogeneous equation, the Wronskian at any point can be given by this formula. So proof is very simple. What we'll do is we'll just differentiate the Wronskian. So Wronskian is the determinant y1, y2, y1 dash, y2 dash. So that is nothing but y1, y2 dash minus y2, y1 dash. And Wronskian we can define at each point x. That means it is a function of x. So we can differentiate it with respect to x. So what we get is we get derivative of y1 y2 dash minus y2 y1 dash, and that equals, so here we'll use the derivative of the multiplication of functions. So essentially we'll get y1 dash y2 double dash plus y2 double dash y1. I will get y2 dash here minus y1 double dash y2 minus y1 dash y2 dash. So we can see that first and last term is same, so we can cancel that two terms because they have different sign, and essentially we get y2 double dash y1 minus y1 double dash y2. And then what we know is y1 and y2 are solution of this equation. That means y1 and y2 both satisfy this equation, right? So we can write y2 dash as, we know that y2 satisfies this equation. So that means for y2 function we get this equation, and y1 is also solution of this differential equation. That means that also satisfies the given differential equation. So from this equation we substitute y2 double dash, then y2 double dash is minus ux y2 dash minus rx y2 times y1 minus y1 double dash is again minus qx y1 dash minus rx y1 times y2. All right, so this formula we are just substituting y2 dash and y1 dash using this equation, and then we can see that the rx term here is, the coefficient of rx is minus y1 y2, here the coefficient of rx is plus y1 y2. So rx term will cancel out and we will get only qx term. And if we take in the qx term, if we take minus common, then the remaining coefficient is y1 y2 dash minus y2 y1 dash. Right, you can verify this. So essentially what we are getting is minus qx times, this is Wronskian, so why we have taken minus common, because we are getting here Wronskian itself. So what is Wronskian? Wronskian is y1 y2 dash minus y2 y1 dash, right? So essentially what we got the derivative of Wronskian w is minus qx times Wronskian. So that means it is satisfying the differential equation, which is homogeneous linear first order differential equation. So therefore w y1 y2 x is a solution of the differential equation dy by dx plus qxy is equal to 0, right? Because when we substitute y, we are getting instead of y we substitute w y1 y2, we are getting this equation. And then we know what is the solution of this equation. The solution we get is w y1 y2 at x is constant times e power integral x0 to x us ds, right? So we have already derived this solution in previous lecture for using the variation of parameter method, right? The solution of homogeneous part, that is this one. And since here we know the initial condition, the integral will be from x naught to x in this particular case, right? Here we have not discussed initial condition, but now we are considering initial condition, and the constant c is also we can determine because of the initial condition. So whenever we substitute x equals to x naught in this e power formula, the integral will be zero, right? Because integral from x naught to x is zero. The e power zero is one. So using that, we get the c equals to w y1 y2 at x naught. So we can determine the constant itself, and the solution is this one. Yeah, and using this formula, what we will conclude is the Wronskian. Suppose Wronskian is zero at certain point x naught, right? At some point x naught in the interval, the Wronskian is zero. So that means what? This is zero. If this is zero, this whole term will be zero, and that means the Wronskian is zero at every x. Right. So whenever Wronskian, the use of this solution, whatever we derive, is that if Wronskian is zero at some point x naught in the interval, then Wronskian is zero at every point x in the interval. And converse is always true, that if Wronskian is zero at every point, then it is always zero at particular point. So this is the application. So what this says, that instead of checking the Wronskian is zero over the whole interval, we just need to check the Wronskian is zero at a particular point in the interval. Yeah, so let us see one application of this result. So now we can use this result to identify whether two solutions of given differential equation is independent or not. So let y1 and y2 be two solutions of the equation y double dash plus px y dash plus 2x y is equal to 0. Then, and we have a fixed point in the interval. Then y1 and y2 are linearly independent if and only if the Wronskian for these two particular function y1 y2 at point x naught is non-zero. Yeah, let us try to prove this theorem. So one part of this theorem is very easy, so let us consider that first. So we suppose that Wronskian of these two function at some particular point is non-zero, right? What we want to prove is that we want to prove y1 and y2 is linearly independent. So whenever we want to check two vectors in the vector space are independent, we take the linear combination to be zero, and then we prove their coefficients are zero. Right. So let's start with that. So c1 by 1x plus c2 y2x is zero. Right, so we are starting with a linear combination of y1 and y2, we are equating it to be zero. Our goal is to prove that C1 and C2 both are zero. If we can prove that, then it will follow that Y1 and Y2 are independent. Right, that is what we discussed, that the definition of independent in the previous lecture, this particular thing. Yeah, so we know that Y1 and Y2 are two functions. So what we can do is we can differentiate this equation with respect to X. So what we get is we get another equation, C1 Y1 dash X plus C2 Y2 dash X is equal to zero. Right. So now we have system of two equations, which is linear in variables C1 and C2. Right. So if we fix the value of X, so substitute X equals to X naught, we get the equation C1 Y1 X naught plus C2 Y2 X naught is equal to zero. Second equation we'll get is this one. Right. And what else we know is that we know that Wronskian is non-zero. So Wronskian is non-zero means Y1, the Wronskian is Y1 Y2 dash minus Y2 Y1 dash. This term is non-zero. Right, that is coming from the definition of Wronskian. So whenever we have two linear equation in the unknown C1 and C2, and the coefficients, that is what will be the coefficient matrix of these two equations, the variables are C1 and C2, so constant are Y1 X naught, coefficient of variable C2 is Y2 X naught, coefficient of C1 in second equation is Y1 dash X naught, and coefficient of variable C2 in second equation is Y2 dash X naught. Right. So since we can call this system of equation A. Right. So since system of so since Wronskian is non-zero, the system of linear equation A has, so what can we say about the solution? If we have two linear equation and coefficient matrix has determinant non-zero, then the solution is unique, because this is a homogeneous equation. All right, so the system A has unique solution. C1 and C2 both variable to be zero. Right. So this homogeneous system in variable C1 and C2 has trivial solution in this case. So whenever, what we have proved is we started with a linear combination of Y1 and Y2 to be zero. We proved C1 and C2 both are zero. So that means Y1 and Y2 are linearly independent solutions of the equation, given equation. And now the converse part we want to prove. So conversely, what we need to show? We need to show that the set of two vectors y1 and y2 is at Li implies the Wronskian is zero is non-zero at some point. In the interval, right? So instead of proving this particular statement, we prove the equivalent statement. Which is whenever the Wronskian is zero at every point, implies this set is not Li. So not Li means it is LD, linearly dependent. Right. So we will prove this statement. The second statement to prove the first statement, because these both statements are equivalent. So let us start with the assumption that suppose the Wronskian is zero for all x in I, and again we want to prove y1 y2 is LD. That means we start with the linear combination to be zero. That means c1 y1 x plus c2 y2 x to be zero. So what we get is its derivative will give us c1 y1 dash x plus c2 y2 dash x to be zero. Now this is again a system of linear equation. Let us call it system B. So what can we say about system B? System B is a system of linear equation in variable c1 and c2, and its coefficient matrix has determinant zero. So coefficient matrix of this homogeneous system has determinant zero. So we know that whenever we have system like 2x plus 3y is equal to 0 and x minus y is 0, and the coefficient matrix which is 2, 3, 1, minus 1. So this is minus 2, minus 3, which is minus 5, is non-zero. So the system always has, yes. Any doubt? So such a system always has infinite solution, right? So such a system has infinite solution because we have determinant of the so here coefficient matrix has determinant zero, but what I'm saying is that it has, let us call it, if you have such a system such that determinant is zero, then such a system has infinite solution. So we have already seen these things in linear algebra. So that result we are using here, that whenever the determinant of the coefficient matrix of given system has determinant zero, given homogeneous system has determinant zero, we get infinite solution. So that is to say that we get at least one solution c1 comma c2 such that एटलीस्ट वन ऑफ सी वन एंड सी टू इज नॉन जीरो, राइट? वन ऑफ द सी वन एंड सी टू इज नॉन जीरो. So what does this means? We have considered the homogeneous equation, that is c1 y1 plus c2 y2 is 0. That implies that, we proved that at least one of the c1 and c2 is non-zero. So what does it mean? It means that the functions are LD. The solutions y1 and y2 is linearly dependent. If you get both c1 and c2 to be 0, it is independent. Both are not 0, that means it is linearly dependent. Yeah, so this is regarding whenever we get the solutions, two solutions, how to check whether it is Li or Ld. But the question is how to find the solution y1 and y2 from the given differential equation. So again, finding solution of given differential equation is not easy even in first order differential equation. But in certain special cases, we are getting the solution. So let us first consider homogeneous second order linear differential equation. With constant coefficients. So whenever we have such a system of linear equation, it is possible to find two solutions of this differential equation, and not only we can find the solution, we will always get independent solution. So let us see what is the general form of such equation. So consider the equation. So here equation is a y double dash plus b y dash plus c y is equal to 0, where x belongs to I. So here what we are saying, that the equation is homogeneous. That means right hand side we are getting 0, it is linear, that is also clear, because we are getting functions which are coefficient of y, y dash and y double dash, but these functions are constant. So that means a, b and c are constant. Constants means their numbers. So whenever we have such a differential equation, for example 4y double dash minus y dash plus 3y is equal to 0, so such a differential equation is of this form, because coefficient of y double dash, y dash and y is number. So in solving, whenever we solve a differential equation in second order differential equation, what we will do is we will first guess the solution, like in the variable of parameter method we guess the solution and then we derive the function v, right? The same way we will try here some trial solution. So let yx to be e power mx be a trial solution. So using this equation, call this equation number. Equation number H. So this is homogeneous equation, let us call it H. So be a trial solution of equation H. then what shall we get? So if y is e power mx, we know that y dash is m times e power mx, right? And y double dash will be m square e power mx, right? And substituting this, y dash and y double dash in equation h, so what we'll get is we'll get a times y double dash, that is a times m square e power mx plus b times y dash. So y dash is m e power mx plus c times y. So y is e power mx is equals to 0. So what has happened? We have essentially got a polynomial am square plus bm plus c times e power mx to be 0. Right? And we know that this holds for every x in the interval. And e power mx is a non-zero. This function takes non-zero values. So that means we can cancel out e power mx both the sides, or in other words, multiplying by e power minus mx, we get the polynomial am square plus bm plus c is equals to 0. This polynomial we'll call polynomial of variable m. So starting from the first order, second order linear differential equation homogeneous with the constant coefficients, we got this corresponding polynomial. And that polynomial, the condition we are getting is this polynomial is zero. So this will give us the value m, right? We know how to solve the second order polynomial. By the binomial formula, we'll get this value of m to be minus b plus or minus root delta, which is b square minus 4ac by 2a. We'll get two values of m out of a given differential equation. So we'll get two functions essentially. The first function will be minus b minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a, and the other function is minus b plus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So this is the two different value of m actually. So we'll call this is m1 and m2. And the solution is y1x is e power m1x, and y2x is e power m2x. So depending on whether the roots of this binomial are same, different, or complex number, we will get three different cases, right? And then we'll see whether in all these three cases whether the solution is independent or not using the Wronskian. Yeah, so let me stop this here only.